I have a grocery haul to share with you today, so stay tuned for the names of all of these grocery items and some helpful phrases and idioms that you can use to talk about it. Welcome to English Coach 3Ts. I'm Tanya, and today I'm so excited to share a story with you that I wonder if you can relate to. So Tiana so graciously showed me how I can look up how much money I've spent on groceries. And she thought this was a really cool thing I could do on my banking app. So I checked it out and discovered that since the beginning of this year, my groceries that I normally pay for had a graph that looked like this. Meaning that last month I discovered I had paid more than double to buy pretty much the same groceries that I always buy. So as I'm sure you are aware, the economy has been really bad here in the United States and worse in many countries around the world. So I've made it a goal to spend less than what I normally spend, way less than what I normally spend on groceries over this next month to try and make up for all the money I've spent on groceries. Can you relate? I know the economy has hit people all over the world. What is it like in your country? Let me know in the comments below. So at the beginning of this video, you heard me say I was gonna share my grocery haul. Haul is a word you've probably heard all over Instagram and YouTube. It is a new way of saying all the things I've recently bought. This word is more commonly used as a verb to haul something in a wagon or a wheelbarrow, maybe leaves or things in your yard. It could be something heavy like rocks or sand. But more recently, you've been hearing people all over social media talking about it like I'm talking about it today. So let me share with you some of the things I got, what we call them, and some of the normal prices. So I'm a bit hot and sweaty because I just got home with our food boxes. So I'm gonna start with the stuff that needs to go in the refrigerator so Tiana can put it away. We got butternut squash risotto. I was gonna try to guess the cost of these things, but I can tell you that because this is gluten-free and a couple things like that, it's probably, I'm gonna guess between $3 and $5 for this. We also got a half gallon of organic grass-fed milk. This is easily $5 or $6. This frozen brown rice, I have not purchased this brand, but I used to buy it at Trader Joe's. I'm thinking this is also in the range of $3 to $5, and I love brown rice, so that's awesome. This is not something I would normally buy. It's a breakfast sandwich. It looks like you put it in a microwave, and it looks like it was probably frozen at one time. We don't have a microwave, but it has sausage, cheese, and eggs on it. I think that is all of the refrigerated items. Okay, so some of the unrefrigerated items, we got a box of strained tomatoes. So kind of like canned tomatoes, but in a box, which I prefer. No idea on the price of this, somewhere between $1 and $2. 3 boxes of Annie's organic mac and cheese. I haven't bought mac and cheese since I had children at home, but this is organic, and sometimes it's non-GMO. Sometimes it's also gluten-free. I don't think those are. So you can see that the boxes of this organic mac and cheese, the boxes are all squished. I will take a squished box since I'm getting this for practically free. So you could say that these boxes have been crumpled, squished, or damaged. Damaged is a word you're gonna wanna have in your vocabulary. So be sure to watch this video for some tips and tricks on how to remember vocabulary words. Okay, chunk chicken breast in a bag, chunk chicken breast. So the Annie's, I know these run about $2 a box and we got 3 of them. The chicken breast, in a bag, I'm gonna say $2 to $3 for this, maybe even more. depending. And we got also, we got two of those, which is awesome because I have a recipe that uses canned chicken and I think this is better than canned. I don't eat this kind of peanut butter, but Talia, my younger daughter, does. This is a huge jar of peanut butter. I'm gonna say somewhere between $5 and $10. And looks like only one canned item this time, which is really unusual. We usually have a lot of canned things that we don't eat and then we give them away. This one is pork and beans, an American favorite. Again, not something I've been eating recently, but because of the price of food, probably gonna have me some pork and beans. Here is a smaller box of crushed tomato with onion, like you could use in a recipe. Again, probably about the $1 mark. Penne pasta, probably about the $1 mark. This, I've never seen a package like this. I wonder if you have a package like this in your country. It looks like there are a dozen eggs here. 1% goes to the planet. Certified humane. We usually get cage-free organic eggs, but this says holistic farming, so that is something I'm happy about. Jasmine rice quinoa. This is right up my alley since I try to eat gluten-free. And a handful of peppers for cooking, so that's nice. This, I forgot to say prices. Those eggs, well, I pay $6 a dozen for my eggs, and I'm thinking those are in the same range. This is probably about $1 to $2. The peppers, probably not that much. I'm gonna say less than $1 for them. I hope that you're learning some new vocabulary or you're improving your listening skills. If videos like this are helpful to you, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe so that you don't miss any English lessons in the future. All right, let's get back to it. A bag of white rice, maybe $1. Oh, here's another frozen thing. Crispy cauliflower florets. We love these because we can put them with buffalo sauce and have like chicken wings, but vegetarian. Oh, here's another. Oh! Yeah, beefless sliders. So like vegetarian, little vegetarian hamburgers, also frozen. I'm gonna say for the cauliflower thing, maybe $3, and the sliders, do you have any guesses on those sliders too?
I would say at least $5.
Probably $5 for both of those, she thinks. Okay, ramen noodles, you can get these for 25 cents a bag. Chan, I know is gonna love those because it's spicy. Toothpaste, we don't typically buy this type or store-bought toothpaste, but Talia does, so we'll let her have this one. Probably $2, maybe $3 for that. Two of these cute little squashes, maybe about $1, depending on if they're organic or not. A bag of ciabatta rolls, probably $3. Four of these kind of onions, maybe about $1. Oh, a little lemon. These have been about 50 cents and there's two of those. We'll have to use these lemons soon because they're on their last leg. Do you know what it means if we say something is on its last leg? It means that it's not gonna last too much longer. This lemon is a little bit squishy. Squishy meaning it's not firm. So we will use it soon. And a cucumber, maybe also in the range of $1. It looks like it came from a local farm. Blue corn chips. I usually pay about $2 a bag for these. Veggie sticks, grain-free, organic olive oil. Probably $2 or $3 for this. A watermelon. I haven't bought a watermelon in a long time. This is small, but I'm gonna guess, again, $2 or $3. And these, a box of these kids' chewy peanut butter chocolate chip snack bars. These are gonna be, there's 10 bars in here. I'm gonna say this box probably cost between $5 and $8. They gave us this one, and then when we were leaving, they asked if we wanted some more, and they gave us this whole box of these. So I think there's one, two, four, probably five of these in here. I'm gonna guess we got between $25 and $40 worth of snack bars. A bag of popcorn, probably $2. Plantain chips, probably $3. More plantain chips, again, $3. I don't eat these, but my daughter Talia likes these. They might even have the price on them. Probably $2 each. Is this something you like eating? More blue corn chips in the single serving size. These are probably like a dollar each, to be honest, even though the other bag is bigger. Okay, the extra virgin cold pressed olive oil, local olives from California. And we refilled the bottle. So we got this before, we refilled it this time. So another bottle doesn't go in the trash or need to be recycled. We would have recycled it, but it's even better if you can reuse it. I think that's all. I cannot tell you how excited I am. And the cost of groceries has just been sky high here. And I have lots of things that I will eat and things that I can share with my children. And nothing that we won't use this time. So thank you. The day after I filmed this video, I went to the grocery store and bought these three items that cost $15, the same cost as all of the groceries you saw in this video. Needless to say, the rising prices of groceries in the United States has been huge. If this video was helpful, you can help us out by giving us a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any more like this one. And as long as we've been talking about food, you can check out this video about things in the kitchen to help you prepare all this food, or this one that YouTube has already picked out for you. See you there.